Yo, 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 Paula Poundstone is here. Of course, we revere her as a comedian, an actress, an author, host and podcaster, and now rapper.
I'm a rapper now.
Okay.
Sweeping the Nation.
It is.
My number one single.
All right.
Sweeping the Nation.
We're going to listen to the single in a moment, but before we do, I think to introduce your podcast, and I don't know if this was an audition to be your hype man, but Frank is in the, as they say,
yes,
is in the mix.
Frank Buckley was a key part of both my rap song and Nobody Listens to Paula Poundstone.
I think that's a great title, by the way.
It is a great
title.
Because
it's subversive then just to listen.
You know what's great is that my fans call themselves nobodies.
Okay.
They'll come up to me and they'll say, I'm a nobody.
Oh, that's
it's so
dear.
Flattering. It's lovely. Because they're somebodies to us.
Here's a snippet of just a little bit of Frank's contribution. Mm. Observe.
Poundstone plans to drop her first rap song. It's a deeply personal statement tentatively titled, Butterfingers Used to Have the Best Nougat.
Nice.
Well,
you know, Frank told me, he was a guest on my podcast, he was terrific, and he told me that he dreamed of doing this his entire life.
It's what I've always wanted to do.
In elementary school, he would do broadcast. He would say, you know, some mysterious large yellow vehicles entering the driveway. We'll get back to you after this message.
I've always wanted to be the guy before the concert who goes to the Mall of Microphones and goes, check one.
Oh,
that would be a good job too, isn't it?
Yeah.
So was it Candy that inspired this rap? Or what particularly?
Well,
because I like Candy.
Butterfingers has been bought by a new company.
Mm.
And one day I got some Butterfinger chips very enthusiastically. I popped one into my mouth. It was repulsive.
Uh-oh.
I'm looking around for the date. I'm like, what's wrong
right.
with this? And then I see it, the harrowing red corner with improved recipe.
New and improved.
Yeah. Everything. My heart just crumbled. There's nothing to look forward to now.
Okay.
Life is done.
Well, you know, they redid all the Hostess stuff, too.
Yeah.
And that has not been...
It's been a problem.
Right.
And so the point in my rap is that we have so many things that need change.
Right.
But not my Butterfingers.
All right, here we go. This is Paula's rap. Listen in.
Of all the things that need to change, there are many. In the Butterfinger recipe, there weren't any. Can't provide equal opportunity? That's lunacy. Anyone can see. Can't they address that deep regret instead of just f***ing with my chocolate? Some things need to change. Some things need to change. But not my Butterfingers. But not my Butterfingers.
I think is the most intimate and personal of expressions. Was there trepidation when you got behind the mic?
Great trepidation.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm pretty comfortable in most venues.
Yes.
But yeah, no, it was. But I had a great. I had the great Jay Deal producing he kept saying I was great, which I want Jay Deal to be my life coach because. Man, that guy can lie to you.
Right.
And was the word
flow ever used? Did he say let it flow?
I can't remember anymore.
Okay.
But that would be a good.
Yeah.
You might want to get into producing rap because that's a good thing to say.
Right. I think so. Yeah. That's the least I can do.
Yeah.
Downtown stand-up performance. So this to me would be the holy grail.
I'm very excited about. I'm
all right.
at the Ace Hotel.
Great place.
In downtown L.A. And I've never been there before. Have you been there?
I have been there. That's a big, it's a really great room, but that's the substantial room.
Oh, is it big?
Yeah.
Well, I'll pack the front row.
Okay.
Will I feel
you
good
rap
about that.
In front of people?
Likely not.
Okay. Yeah. I love that.
A lot of technological work made it
likely
possible
not.
For me
funny.
To rap. I mean, you know,
how about it's
if
your
the
theme
crowd,
song before you come in?
Oh, there
if
you
the
go.
Crowd rises up and demands
right.
I feel
I
will have to. But,
and do you think there might be a requirement for Frank to do the live introduction?
Oh,
Frank's got to be there.
Yeah.
One of the things in my contract is I have to have a box of Kleenex, some diet sodas, and I don't go on if Frank's not there.
You're a hype man.
That's exactly what I need.
Now, something like Democratic bait tonight. Will you watch potentially for fodder?
I thought you said Democratic bait tonight.
Well, might be. But is that a place for material to be gathered?
Well, sometimes you can't help it, but I'm not watching for fodder. I'm watching as a citizen.
Right.
You know, wanting to make an intelligent vote. And, you know, we're teetering.
you know, we, you know, the Butterfinger issue recedes.
Right.
As important as it is.
Look, you know, every one of us is going to have to be, what is it? What was Bolton National?
Security advisor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, every one of us is going to have to take a shift as national security advisor. That's part of the reason I'm going to watch the debates, just so I know
something was going on. Mr. Proctor, scroll down to the end. You can catch Paula Poundstone live at the theater. At the Ace Hotel, which is really a great theater. There's a lot of history in that theater.
Do we have time for one thing?
Sure.
Okay, do you know what this is?
What? Wait, we need to see you. Hang on.
No.
I don't know.
No, not sure.
That is PE in online school.
I got it.
November 28th, ladies and gentlemen.
Show starts at 7. Tickets at $35 to get your information. It's paulapoundstone.com. Nice to see you.
Thank
ladies
you, Paula.
And gentlemen, Paula Poundstone.
Thank you so much, Frank Buckley. Dreamed of it his entire life.
That's true.